And as you know, I was recently appointed to an honor to be named the chair of the Senate's Aging Committee. It's something that's very near and dear to my heart. I love my seniors. And it's a role that I do take very seriously. So I'm very particularly interested in hearing from everything you had to say today. And I can't thank you enough for taking the time to participate in this critical process. I also think our goals are very similar. We're both here to make sure that our New York seniors have a voice in this budget. And to make sure that they get the resources that they need to continue to live their lives out here in New York. Because we know that's very important. We want to keep our seniors here. So I just have a question with regard to the creation of the Office for the Community Living. Is there going to be any kind of a forum for public input? Was anything mentioned about that?
Oh, absolutely. The language in the budget just provides the framework to give us the opportunity to look at synergies of what's happening at the federal level, and some of the activities are happening here at the state level. So in 2012, the Administration on Aging was folded in to a new office called Administration on Community Living, which pulled together aging and disabilities. The work that we're doing through the No Wrong Door is similar in that structure. So what we wanted to do was engage stakeholders, including advocates, constituents, the legislature, to talk about what's going on at the federal level, what's going on at the state level, and are there opportunities here at the state level to build this Office of Community Living, and then what would the recommendations be on how that would look.
And also, last year in the legislature increased the funding for the community services for the elderly program by $5 million. So I was wondering, can you provide an update on how the increased funding impacted waiting lists for aging services at the local level?
We are tracking the usage of that money and the impact that it's having, but we won't have a full picture until the close of the state fiscal year. So shortly after March, we'll have numbers for you on that.
Okay, thank you.